On the morning of August 16th, a mere 2 days ago, something unexpected to most people occurred in Australia. And no, this unexpected event did not involve the discovery of yet another species of one of the world's most venomous snakes. Instead, at 9:49 a.m. local time, the ground northwest of Brisbane began to shake back and forth, causing audible rattling of objects and many structures due to a magnitude 5.6 earthquake. The shaking from this earthquake lasted for between 5 and 15 seconds, marking the largest on-land rather than offshore earthquake to strike Queensland in 97 years. While by definition, this was technically only a moderate magnitude earthquake, we have seen firsthand what such a moderate magnitude can do in a worst-case scenario if it strikes right underneath a major city. For that, I bring up the fatalities, injuries, and more than $1 billion in damage in earthquake of the exact same magnitude, that being a 5.6, caused in New South Wales 3 days after Christmas in 1989. However, apart from electricity being temporarily knocked out at approximately 10,000 homes, no other damage of any kind was reported and there were no casualties. And this is largely owed due to the somewhat sparsely populated area where it struck, with perhaps around only 10 people living in areas where some form of minor structural damage could have happened, marked by the yellow MMI-6 outline. Compare that total with the 270,000 people who lived in an MMI-6 or MMI-7 intensity shaking zone during the magnitude 5.6 earthquake in 1989. What I am trying to say is that we got lucky this time, although I must admit the 1989 earthquake was exceptionally damaging for its moderate magnitude. So, as many people may have just discovered, with up to 5 million people having felt Saturday's earthquake, Australia does experience earthquakes, just not as often and generally through not as large of events as its neighboring countries of New Zealand, Indonesia, and Papua New Guinea. While parts of those countries lie on or in close proximity to a major tectonic plate boundary, the Australian mainland exists far away from such earthquake sources. However, this does not mean it's immune to tectonic stresses, as mainland Australia is still slowly moving north-northeastwards at an average of 7 centimeters a year, and this is not occurring universally at the same rate. While this uneven motion can cause compressive stresses to build up, the main source of stresses originates from the tectonic collision with various plate boundaries to the far north, which creates a decent amount of compressive forces. These then build up over time until a part of the Earth's crust moves to accommodate this strain best, with that generally being a reverse fault that generates an earthquake. Yes, while reverse faults accommodate compressive stresses, normal faults accommodate extensional stresses. While the earthquake which struck might at first seem to have occurred in close proximity to a mine, specifically the Shamrock Mine, I currently see no evidence that this event was an induced earthquake by mining activity. And this is not an insult to the official location given of the earthquake, but in my opinion, there's a decent chance the earthquake actually struck 10 to 16 kilometers away from the spot given. I was able to spot and outline 3 north-northwest trending fault lines which could have been the source of this earthquake, one of which even has a visible surface exposure. However, since many ridges in the area also trend in the same orientation, any one of them could theoretically also contain a previously unknown fault line. So, in the next few days, and maybe even weeks, aftershocks or additional generally smaller earthquakes after the main shock are likely. However, these occur in the same area and decrease in frequency as time since the main shock increases, and the largest aftershock averages 1.2 magnitudes lower than the main shock, so in this case a 4.4. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and YouTube members for supporting my work.